Hi, Evan here with MimeoStem, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to transform images into 3D prints, such as this business card here. So let's take a closer look. This 3D printed business card looks just okay on the desk here, but the real magic happens when you hold it up to a light. This technique is called a lithophane, and you can use it for anything from lamps to ornaments, even coasters, or in this case, a business card. Now, to help you build something similar, I've created a template on Google Slides. All you need to do is follow the link in the description, and then on this page, click the blue button that says Use Template. That'll make a copy in your own Google account. Now, this is a Google Slides file, so everything here is customizable. Obviously, you're going to want to change the name, job title, contact information. You'll probably want to change to another photo as well. I have used here a photo that does not have a background. You might need to do a little bit of design customization here. If you want to use a picture that does have a background, you'll probably want to make sure that it's correctly sized so the background goes all the way to the top of your page. Maybe it splits your business card in half, something like that. And then obviously replace some of the other graphics here that you can see I've customized for Boxlight and our branding with Boxlight and MimeoStem. Now, however you decide to customize this, it's important to keep in mind that for the lithopane, anything that is a darker color is going to print a little thicker, and anything that is a lighter color is going to print a little thinner. You can see here that I have not made the background pure white. I kept it as a lighter gray option. I found that printed a little bit better than just pure white for me, and I also like that my skin tone here is a little bit brighter than the background. It helps make that picture stand out a little bit when it is printed. And you may have to play around with some of the settings for the colors and also the font widths, any icons you use to make sure that those are both large enough and clear enough to show up once you print this in 3D. Now, when you are ready to print your card, all you have to do here is go up to File, and then go to Download and choose the PNG option. We're going to create an image out of this slide. All right, now that we've downloaded our file, we need to open up RoboPrint. RoboPrint is MimeoStem's slicer program. This is where you import 3D files to send them to your RoboPrinters. In this case, we're going to be importing an image. So I'm going to go to File and Load File. And then I'm going to find in my Downloads folder my new picture. Now it's going to give you a few options here, and I've worked out the best dimensions that I've found. Feel free to play around with my recommendations a little bit if you're not happy with how your print is turning out, but here is what I would do. First of all, we're going to keep this as a plane. You can see here if you're printing a Christmas ornament, or maybe a lamp that would be more of a cylinder. You might want to change that option, but here we obviously have a flat plane. Also, depending on the graphic design of your card, you may want to consider making lighter parts of your business card into thicker 3D prints. Most of the time, though, I stick with darker being the thicker print, just because then it shows up in its natural look when I print it as a lithopane. Now here's the real important steps. We need to change the base thickness, so the absolute thinnest this card is going to be, and the thickest it's going to be. So 0.6 is very close. I have tended to go with 0.67 millimeters, so 0.66 millimeters, just to make it a little bit more robust. You don't want your business card to crack too easily if someone tries to just bend it slightly. And then 4 millimeters is much too thick for a business card. That is really bulky and it won't fit in anyone's pocket easily, so we're going to change that from 4 to 2 millimeters. Now, the last part here is our width and our depth. The standard business card dimensions are 89 millimeters by 51 millimeters. So you can see we're very close on our dimensions here. We'll just change that to 89 and we should be good to go. Now, once we press OK, you'll see it's imported my business card right here. There's one last step we need to do to convert this prior to printing, and that is to rotate it. So if you print it flat like this, all the different layers of plastic will appear a little bit like a topographic map. That might be a look you're going for, but I find it's a little less detailed and a little less pleasing than if we just go ahead and use our rotate command here on the left. And then you just need to rotate along the x-axis by 90 degrees. So now our card stands up. And that's all there is to it. The next thing we're gonna do is start slicing. And we can use all the default settings here. I have a Robo E3. Just make sure you're matched up to the correct printer that you have. And then we are going to also choose a fine print profile. That's a layer height of 0.12 millimeters. You can certainly print this with the standard print height, but I find a little finer layer, a little more detail, really adds a lot to that business card. And we go ahead and slice. And once it's done, you'll get this preview here. You can see I have opted to include a raft. I did not delete the raft. It should be there by default. I do that because this is a very thin print and I don't want it detaching from the base while it's printing. And you can also see this is going to take almost 2 hours to complete. That's pretty normal for these 3D business cards that I have found. Obviously, if that is too slow for you, you may want to lower the print quality or perhaps consider making a smaller business card. Now we're ready to begin printing. RoboPrint allows you to either download this file onto a USB stick, which then you can take to your printer, or my preference is to connect to a printer on my local network. So here in my office, I have my Robo E3 connected to the internet, and it's able to detect it automatically through RoboPrint. All I need to do is click this arrow here and choose the file name that I'm going to use, and it's going to send that code right over to the 3D printer to begin printing. You should notice your printer start to work at this point. The screen will light up saying that it's receiving a file, and then it will go through the typical process of heating up the nozzle and beginning the print. Let's take a look. Now, as I said, this print usually takes about 2 hours to complete. Obviously, this is sped up quite a bit, but when it's done, you should have an excellent looking 3D business card. And with that, our 3D printed business card is complete. Thanks so much for watching. Hopefully you learned a little bit more about how to use RoboPrint and the Robo system of printers to create something really fun and unique. See you in the next video.